Thank you for checking out this No Spoilers movie review. This one is for a short film, actually. It's called El Gigante. It is a 2015 film by Gigi Saul Guerrero. And some people may be saying, why are you doing a short film? That's not a feature film. You're usually just doing feature films. And that's correct. I'm usually only doing reviews on feature films. But I feel like this is important. Well, first of all, I wanted to check it out because the premise sounded interesting and I just had interest. But the other thing is I want to raise awareness. I feel like we all should be raising awareness about short film is film still. And I personally believe that we should have more short films and we should have more focus on short films. And one of the things I applaud with the Shudder streaming service is that they're adding short films onto that streaming service and not calling it out. Like, they let you know that it's short films, but they're treating them the same as feature films. Like, when they put out their press releases saying, these are the things that are coming this month, they're putting the short films right there with the feature-length films. And I think that's important. In my opinion, I think short films are harder to do than feature length because you have a lot less time to develop story, to develop characters, to get people involved in it. So, yes, I could see people having an argument where it's a little bit easier in the sense that you can keep people's attention longer. So writing a feature length or shooting a feature length, you need to come up with more to hold attention. So for that aspect, I would say that is correct. But overall, I think short stories are harder because you don't have enough time. You don't have a lot of time to like get a good story done and to have people get involved with characters because you need to develop them to some degree. So when a short film is done well, it's kind of mind-blowing in my opinion because of that. So this is currently streaming on the Shudder streaming service, so I would definitely tell you to check it out. And you should definitely just check it out. It's 14-minute runtime. 14 minutes. Everyone has 14 minutes somewhere. Check it out. You know, Shudder has a phone app, so just watch it on your phone while you're on the toilet or whatever. So, yeah. So, El Gigante. Gigi Saul Guerrero. Now, she mostly has done films I've never heard of, but they're all kind of seem to have like a Latin angle to them, probably because of her heritage. She doesn't live in a Latin country. She actually currently lives in Vancouver, Canada, but she obviously is very tied back to her heritage, and so she kind of goes for that angle when she's doing film, which is cool. Do what you want. The other thing is, it seems like she's done a lot with luchadors, and with El Gigante, a luchador is very prominently featured. One thing that I need you to know is that it is subtitled, it is in Spanish, but at 14 minutes, there's not that much to read. And actually, in the context of even the runtime, there isn't that much to read. There's some dialogue in the beginning, and then after that, it's like no dialogue. There's a lot of no dialogue portions of this, which actually really plays in its favor. I think a lot of times it's better to show as opposed to say. And with this one, I think that's a prime example. So the camera work, one of my big problems with this is actually that the camera work is very, very shaky and not, it doesn't seem intentionally shaky either. It's just kind of like get a tripod or just get someone else in there to help hold the camera kind of still. And it gets to be distracting, it gets to be annoying and slightly nauseating at certain times because with, you know, enough motion in a camera, you'll be like, okay, woo. At least I'm that way. So there's wrestling in this, because like I was saying, you know, focus on luchador, there's wrestling in it, which to me felt really ridiculous. It just made the story and the film seem very ridiculous when the wrestling part of it started. And I was just like, this feels so out of place. It feels so weird. But I think that's just because I'm not used to that type of stuff. Because I also have to say that there's something mesmerizing about this film. Like, I can't stop watching it. And even though I was like, this is just kind of weird and it seems kind of odd, I was just like, I can't stop watching it. And I feel like when it was done, I was like, I kind of feel like I want more. Like, I need more. So it's got something. Like, as some people would say, it's got a je ne sais quoi. That I don't know, basically. But there's something there, and it is mesmerizing. It's very gritty and gross looking, too. I think that Guerrero did a really good job of getting a kind of nasty environment to it, which goes along very much with the story. And yeah, I think environment matches the story and it looks good and it makes you feel gross and gritty, and I think that's an accomplishment. I think it's definitely a good thing. I would watch another installment of this, to be honest. If she put out another short film with some of the same characters, same premise, all that, like El Gigante 2, El Gigante 3, 4, I would keep coming back and checking it out, because like I said, there's something about it that works. There's something. And I would just be interested to see where it would go. The very end of it had a very tongue-in-cheek, funny finish to it, and it's kind of like going on as the end credits are playing. Made it very playful, kind of joke, kind of like this is a serious film, but it's also like fun and a bit jokey. So I like that. The characters are so odd in this though, and so messed up, and I think that's one of the things that makes it so mesmerizing, is I want to know more. Like, I want the backstories on some of these characters, or all of these characters, because they're so out there and so wacky and messed up that you're just like, show me more. Tell me more. I'm in. So yeah, this can't be a very long review, because it's not a very long movie. I don't think the runtime of this video should be longer than the runtime of the actual movie. So definitely check it out. Like I said, you've got 14 minutes. It's only 14 minutes. Just do it. But I guess in a 5-star rating out of 5 stars, oh man, I'm going to give it a 3. No, I'm going to give it a 3.5. I was between a 3 and a 3.5, but I'm going to give it a 3.5 stars. I definitely think you should check it out. It is pretty good and it's interesting. But yeah, thanks for checking out this video. Hit that subscribe for me, please, please, please. Have you seen El Gigante? Put a comment down there about that. Have you not seen it and you want to? Put a comment down there about that. Do you just want to talk about horror stuff? Put a comment about that down there. Do it. Anyway, you can give me likes if you want to, but the big thing is subscribe. Helps me out a lot in the long run. It is painless for you, literally a second. But anyway, thanks for checking this out regardless. Until next time, keep it brutal.